In accordance with General Assembly Resolution 72/243, I now give the floor to Mr. Kumi Naidoo, Secretary General of Amnesty International.
Now it's all women. Hi,
dear. Madam President, Secretary General, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, we welcome the broad sentiments in the political declaration that governments have agreed to the Mandela Peace Summit. But the truth is, we have heard it before. These are the words that get repeated time and time again without the political will, urgency, determination and courage to make them a reality, to make them really count. But we must make them count, not tomorrow, but right now. Because we are facing multiple crises around the world with people suffering on an unimaginable scale. Without action, without strong and principled leadership, I fear for them, I fear for all of us. Let us remember that Madiba spent the vast majority of his life as a civil society activist. Yet today, as we gather here to honor him, thousands of activists and human rights defenders around the world are imprisoned or have been tortured or have been killed. They include trade unionists, people from NGOs, social movements and religious communities, journalists and those from the arts and culture field. In far too many countries, civic space has been shut down and the right of people to participate actively and freely in public life taken away from them. The preamble of the founding charter of the United Nations starts with the words, "We the peoples, not we the nation states or member nations." And we the people should never allow ourselves to accept injustice. As Martin Luther King once said, "I never intend to adjust myself to religious bigotry. I never intend to adjust myself to racial discrimination. I never intend to adjust myself to economic conditions that will take necessities from the many to give luxuries to the few when millions of God's children are smothering in an airtight cage of poverty in affluent societies." Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I appeal to you today with the spirit of Madiba hanging over us all, not to adjust to the inhumane way we have been treating millions of refugees around the world, not to adjust to the Rohingya population living in an open-air prison under a system of apartheid, not to adjust to the Palestinians in Gaza living under a relentless military blockade which keeps them in poverty and misery, not to adjust to the centuries-old subjugation of indigenous peoples, not to adjust to leaders who espouse xenophobic and fascist narratives or demean or undermine women. Neither we should adjust to the bloodbaths we have seen in Syria, in Yemen, in Iraq, in Afghanistan, in South Sudan and elsewhere. Especially when most of the people who are shedding the blood are civilians and a large proportion of them are women and children. We should not adjust to a systematic exclusion of people living with disabilities, nor to the continuing struggle and marginalization of children and youth everywhere. For humanity must not judge itself on the progress of the most powerful. Humanity should judge itself on those and the welfare of the most vulnerable. Indeed, we have to take care of not only present but future generations as well. We should not adjust to the dismal failure of the powerful to protect civilians in conflict. We particularly must not adjust to the deadlocks that continue to haunt the United Nations Security Council, whose permanent five members too often use the powers not to prevent and stop suffering, but shield themselves and others committing the worst crimes. We should not adjust to the disgraceful levels of impunity and insist on full accountability for gross violations of human rights and crimes against humanity. We urge a renewed respect for UN conventions and norms, that have painstakingly developed on this, the 70th anniversary of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and the 20th anniversary of the Rome Statute, which gave birth to the International Criminal Court. And we call upon those nations that have not yet joined the International Criminal Court to do so, and particularly to three permanent members of the Security Council, the United States, China, and Russia. And we should not adjust to continuing interaction on averting catastrophic climate change while thousands are regularly devastated by extreme weather events from the Philippines to Puerto Rico, where we have seen more than 3,000 lives being lost, making it the biggest natural disaster in United States history. Or for that matter, the reality facing small island states, imminent reality, where the very existence is under threat. To the one leader who still denies climate change, we insist you start putting yourself on the right side of history. Brothers and sisters, the time for bold and courageous action is now. To my fellow activists and advocates, I know that you have what you are facing, but I implore you not to give up. Let the words of Madiba inspire and guide you when he said, courage is not the absence of fear, but it is the overcoming of it. And to all our political leaders, we honor Madiba by picking up the mantle honestly and with integrity of all the struggles he waged. The political declaration being adopted here today is an opportunity for renewed commitment in these troubled times. Think of the most powerless people in the world who will live or die from your choices. Do not disappoint them. Merci beaucoup, muchas gracias, shukran, sheshe, placebo, asante sana. Thank you very, very much.
I thank Mr.